Hello and good morning, my lovely friends. This is Marta from Drupal Sunshine and welcome in my studio. My friends, I wanted to say thank you and hello. And there's a few new friends joining my channel, subscribing to my channel. So thank you so very much for watching and subscribing to my channel. I'm really happy and I wanted to welcome you. I hope you will find some lovely ideas and projects for your own crafting and maybe some good tips here as well. So thank you for subscribing. And if you haven't subscribed already, please consider doing that. This is a huge help for me and for every artist. Actually, this is a great way to show support everyone. Like if you watch some crafty videos and you like whatever the crafty person is creating, please subscribe to their channel, because this is a huge help for all of us. So thank you for doing that, and welcome in my channel, friends. So without any further adoing, I've been missed in action, my friends. I know I haven't been very active on any social media lately, but there's been a few things going on. I've been working on something. I can't share it with you. Oh, even though I'm just like, oh, I don't know if I can keep it secret for a very long time, but I am working on something, and once it'll be ready, I'm sure I will share it with you, but not there yet. Anyway, I wanted to create a video today. I had this video made. I actually have quite a few videos. I haven't been editing anything, so I thought this is a right time to share it, because the Craft Stash is having 25% off on the Christina's products on her card making magic range, and I'm super excited. Whenever I hear that Christina's products are on a sale, I'm just like, oh, bouncing and jumping like a little kiddo. I think whoever watch my channel, you do know I love Christina's design. She is amazing crafter, amazing designer, and I do have this heart feelings, like this, you know, my heart is loving Christina, because she was one of the first ladies I was watching back years ago. I think like almost a decade, like 9 years ago or something. I wasn't even speaking English back then, but I've seen Christina's videos very old. Like she was showing these beautiful cards and I just fell in love thanks to her and other crafters as well. But she taught me, she learned, teach me so much that I'm really, you know, happy. And this is incredible now when I think of it, that years ago I was watching Christina's you know, her videos, and then when she came up with her own range, I was like, oh, she's amazing artist, and oh my goodness. And now I get to share the design team with her. This is unbelievable. I'm super happy, super excited, and grateful and blessed. I am absolutely blessed, my friends. I have so much luck to be able to create, to live. I'm not entirely living off my crafts yet. I hope this is my biggest dream ever, to be fully like sustainable on a card making icon income, so I could be and leave of my passion rather than going to the work, which I still have. I'm slowly reducing my hours at work, concentrating more on this part of my life, so I'm on a good pathway, and I'm not losing my faith, because I am just loving a card making, and this is my life basically. Anyway, going back to the card I've created today. Well, I've made it, I think it was over a month ago, but I'm just only editing the video today. This is the part of her latest release called designer card fronts, and they're absolutely gorgeous. I've already shown one of the circle cards. That was one of my previous videos as well, also create from the same range. I just don't have enough of them. I also made a lovely card for my friend Claire on the craft world as a part of the randomly sent cards. There's a monthly randomly sent cards. You can sign up and receive a card. You're sending a card to someone and then you receive a card from someone else. So it's so super exciting because you can always like make a new friendship, exchange a card with new crafty friend and someone you haven't done it before, or with the friend you've already been swapping with. Always a pleasure. So definitely check it on the craft world, my friends, and I'm just inviting you there. And this is a best crafty place for me, even though I haven't been posting there for 4 days now. But as I've mentioned, I've been super busy, and I only get a little amount of the time since my son is not on the nursery yet. I'm usually spending my days with him when my husband is working, and then I'm trying to accommodate my craft time around him, but I am slowly getting a little bit more time because I've signed him up to the play group 3 hours twice a week now, so I do get a little bit of the freedomness. Although at first day, I must tell you, my friends, the day before I was like, oh, okay, he's going to play group. I'll put him there. Like, I walk him there because it's literally 3 minutes away from my house. I walk him there. I'll come back home and I'm gonna do crafty this and that and that and that. And I just had a full list of the things. And when it actually happened, I put him in a play group. I come back home. I get myself a cup of coffee, and for the 2 hours, because he was staying 2 hours first day, I was staring in my phone. I was keep checking my phone, whether they phone, did I have my sound on, did anyone from the playgroup, you know, message me that he's crying or something. I couldn't be focused on any work, so it didn't work. But I'm hoping within a few next week or so, I'll be more relaxed. He's doing fantastic. I thought he will have a trouble to communicate with kids because English is his second language. We spoke Polish at home. We both Poles, like me and my husband and my son, like we spoke Polish mainly, so he's predominantly using a Polish language, and I'm learning him English a little bit, but this is his second language, so I thought he will be shy. But oh, how wrong I was. He just went there and jumped playing with other kids straight away, and I'm happy and blessed for him that he's having good fun over there. So that should release a little bit more time once it's gonna be increased to a few days. That should take a little bit pressure and give me a more time for crafting as well. Anyway, look on the card I am making, my friends. This die is unbelievably beautiful. This is one of my favorite design dies for forever, and I know I've been using it, I will be using it till the end of my crafting days, because this pattern is just timeless. It's so elegant, it's so delicate, lacy, and it's, oh, the size is just perfect. I love 8x8 size card. This one was actually designed for A5 card. I think when Christina was showing it, she was featuring it on A5 size card, but I'm using 8x8 paper here, and I just love it. And this oval, once you reverse it, because initially that was for a gatefold opening card, her idea, but I am just turning it So that's gave me this beautiful oval shape, and I just absolutely love it. I love it. And this color combination, white with a very, very pale pink color, is just my favorite. I think it will actually, with beautiful design like that, this will work beautifully whatever color you're using. If you use your underlayer with the silver or gold cardstock, that will be perfect for the anniversary or wedding. Or like if it's red, that could be a ruby anniversary. There's so many different possibilities with this dies and timeless design, that this is something I truly, truly love, and I know I will be making most of it. Now, another thing, I've been saying this before plenty, plenty times whenever I'm grabbing Christina set. She is amazing designer. She's not only giving you this basic design shape, she's creating, but she's always looking after you to give you extra flowers, extra leaves, extra all those little teeny tiny bits to finish off your card, to make this perfect project. So here I cut a few flowers and leaves, and what I like to do, I love to cutting them from the white paper. My friends, I feel this is just my personal opinion. Everyone is different, and this is something I prefer to do. I rather cut my flowers from the white cardstock and color them with ink and spray, rather than cut them from the plain paper. I feel whenever I cut my flowers from the plain papers, they kind of look flat. I still have to go over the inks, and what I prefer to use instead, this is my go-to. I've been using it most of the times when I'm creating the flowers. I'm using my Aladdin spray. I just love them. They are absolutely amazing. They're shimmery, they're pastel colors. Well, if you spray them directly on the paper, they are much, much darker. But if you use a sponge like I did here, they just lovely pastel tones. And what is more to those spray, they do have this shimmer, which is like it gives you the same result as you would go over the Wink of Stella pen over the top. But you skip this step because the shimmer is already included in the spray. And one more thing, speaking about the shimmer spray, many bottles from the shimmer spray, they tend to clog. I had this issue with many different companies with the shimmer sprays, that whenever I'm using the shimmer spray and I put it on the shelf and I'm not using it for a very long time, sometimes those nozzles, they clog, they block. So my idea, like what I like to do to resolve this problem, I always keep a glass of the water on the side, and once I finish with my shimmer spray, I unscrew the top. I put this little pipe down the glass of the water, or if I have a matching bottle, if I already have one empty container, I fill up with the water, and then I switch the nozzles, and I'm spraying it a few times to, you know, get this excess shimmer out from the pipe and the nozzle, and then I screw it back to the product. And I know sometimes someone could say, "Oh, but you're losing a little bit of the product." Yes, but it's still better than have this clog bottle and you cannot use it anymore. But if it comes for this Aladdin shimmer spray, they have this new recipe. I don't know what is all like what's into them, but the shimmer is suspended in the liquid. It's not settling down, and they have a little bit different nozzle. You can feel it once you spray it, and I never ever had a problem with these bottles, and I have them for a very, very long time. I've been using them for a very long time, and I'm just I think I've got them for a year or so, something like that, but I never had a problem with them, and they're lovely. And here you can see I use a beautiful sentiment. I've stamped it with the black color ink. This is from another set from the Christina as well. And how beautiful and elegant this sentiment is. And look on the size. Another thing which I love in Christina design, that her sentiments, she's releasing those like a A5 size stamp set with the sentiments for various occasion. They are always good size. They are perfect size to be very elegant. They're not those teeny tiny, and sometimes I'm not likening, because I'm making a large card, I would like my sentiment to be like not micro sentiments in the middle of the big card. But these ones, they are perfect sizing, and how beautifully this looks together, you can see it yourself, my friends. Now, when I'm creating my flowers, I always like to shape them a little bit. And what I'm using for it, my friends, this is a backside of the cork board. This is something you can buy a very, 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 and I'm trying to say too many things at once. But you can buy it very cheaply on any supermarkets, and this is the back side of it. Any cork board, they do have this very condensed sponge. You can use a normal piece of a kitchen sponge as well for shaping your flowers, anything, or even if you wrap a few layers of the material or felt, something, just to give you this a little bit cushioning so you could shape your flowers. But with this cork board, I find them perfectly. You can see mine has been very, very well loved, well used, but it serves me well, and I think I've paid for it like a £2 or something. It was very well purchased tool if it comes for flower shaping. I'm not doing anything difficult here. I am just pressing it gently with my shaping tool, a little bit on the petals, and then one inside for the flower, and then a little bit also on the leaves to give them this nice curve edge, so they're not lying flat. And here I am adding my hot glue to my flowers. I will put them up together, so there's a two layers of the petal for each flower, and then I'm gonna add some little pearl in the center, just to give a little bit like a bling extra thing. I will give you a link if I'll find it on the AliExpress. I've bought them, the one I'm gonna be using for my today's card. I've bought them on the AliExpress, and I will give you a link down below as well. I feel that if you have this elegant flower center, they also make the flowers look much more elegant and classy. I always look for this lovely, like a golden or silver button, something like that, so I could put it in my flowers, because they're just absolutely gorgeous. I've created myself two flowers, and then I will add a giant bow on the bottom, and here you can see how this card is coming together beautifully. I just love it, and this color combination is very subtle, but I think it's just looking perfectly. If I would be doing this card second time, I can see it now, I would probably add a matte and layer underneath this oval shape. I would cut a slightly smaller squares, one from maybe like a silver. I have a little bit silver on this flower center, so I would probably use a golden silver Mary cardstock to cut a square, and then white mat to leave me this teeny tiny square border all over my card front, and I would layer it underneath this oval. But now I am just attaching the oval straight to my card. This is not something like not looking bad. That would be just improve the card if you would add this teeny tiny narrow silver frame to your card. That would be just provide something extra interest on those corner, and the card wouldn't be appealing as plain as it is now. It's still very gorgeous and I love it, but as I'm mentioning, if I would be doing it second time, I would definitely consider to add additional matte and layer of the squares from the silver and white cardstock, just to give extra something going on the corners. And here I am attaching it, and I add my strip of the double-sided tape just on the inside portion. I am leaving this oval piece not attached to the card. I want it to be raised a little bit, so that way this card will be relatively flat. It will still go, it's still suitable to put in a postage, in an envelope. Obviously you will have to add additional like a padded envelope or something around it. I would recommend to not put it straight in the envelope in the mail, but rather put a card in a white envelope and then put it in a bubble envelope for the postage, but it will still be flat to go under the large letter. Paper flowers are quite flat and there's not a lot bulkiness, and but because I didn't glue those oval part or this lacy part to the cardstock, it's slightly raising up, so that way it gives you this illusion of dimension to the card. Even though it's attached flat, there is no foam tape to this design, but because I only attach it in the middle section and I let the edges rise, so that looks much more dimensional when it actually is. And for my center, there is this die which gives you this border, this very interesting border design, which Christina designed actually to hide the flaps. If you ever watch any of her videos introducing you to this designer card front series, she used this these strips to actually embellish the backside of the card once you create this gatefold opening. I'm doing here totally reverse, so I'm just putting it in the center, but to make sure I glue it nice and straight, I help myself with the strip of the white paper and I just glue these pieces to the white paper first before attaching them to the card. And I did that because I wanted to wrap the ribbon around it. Like at first I thought about putting a thin ribbon on the top of this piece, but then I actually decided to go with this very white, I think it's 2 inches organza ribbon, which I love the color and I think it's just matching this card perfectly. So I've changed my mind. Rather than putting ribbon on the top, I put the ribbon on the bottom. And here, this is something I didn't plan, because I was planning to wrap the ribbon around this strip. So I have to raise up my card a little bit just to add this this ribbon. Just gently tackle it underneath and add a drop of the glue so it will hold together nicely. But this is something like, you know, there's always a room to improve or change your card. Just be very, very gentle. If you're trying to you know, lift your element, you already stick to your card, just be very gentle. You can always help yourself with X-Acto knife, or if you rip a little bit piece from underneath and you will cover it with something else, then it would not really matter. But try to be gentle when you're doing that, so you're not going to be destroying your design, my friends. Now I am adding a piece of the foam here on the top of this strip, just to rise it teeny tiny above this this ribbon, and then I will attach my sentiment oval in the middle. And I love that how there is not a lot, like I usually add a lot more to my card, like different elements, lots of different layers, but here, because this this design is so bold, it's so nice, it's so elegant and a large size, I feel that this die is just making your card entirely, doesn't really need anything else, and it's just looking beautifully as it is. I am tying a bow from the same organza ribbon I use on the card already, so it's matching nicely, and then I will attach it to with the hot glue. I'm also finishing off the edges of my bow with my lighter. This is something I prefer, and I recommend it to do it, my friends, because if you're creating a nice card, you definitely want to secure your edges of the bow, because there's nothing wrong worse than you spend an hour to create a beautiful, lovely, you know, looking card, and then you don't secure the edges of the bow, they start shearing and they don't look very appealing, and the ribbon is not looking very nice, and you've got this beautiful card, but then the ribbon is just looking messy. So I always like to use a lighter speaker just to secure this edges from tearing and, you know, getting not looking nice if the card is elegant. And it wouldn't matter if you've got this vintagey distressed look, but for the elegant card, this is something which really, you know, will be visible once you finish your card. And here I am looking for the perfect button for my card center, and I am just attaching my flower composition. This is basically what's finishing my card. Thank you so very much for being here, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I'm probably gonna stay quiet till the next week. I still have got a couple bits I need to finish and wrap my head around, and once I finish, I will be posting as well a note on my Facebook page and on the craft world as well, with when I will have my next live classes. So from this place, I want to invite you there. Thank you so very much. I hope you enjoy it. I'm wishing you a wonderful week, my friends. Stay blessed and see you shortly. And don't forget, please, to subscribe and share my video if you like it, and show it to your friends, and which I am thanking you for that. Stay blessed, my friends, and see you shortly. Bye-bye.